CarPlanet.com.au.
I mean, what I do like to talk about with this, though, is the versatility it gives you. In my situation, for instance, if I was going to a session, it eliminates the need to carry a lot of different bases with me. Because in addition, what you can do is, as Steve was telling you, you can go through and you can listen to the different combinations, and then you can save them in any particular order that you like on those five position switch. So I've got five sounds stored there. Then I can go to the passive mode and have either the same five, or if I like, I put another five sounds there, and I'll get into that in a second. And then here we have Bank Z, which has 15, which they consider them the kind of the best or most usable sounds you might find. You can scroll through those. If you're looking for a particular sound, you're not quite getting it, you scroll through, you find one you like, you can immediately assign it to here. And then you have that sound available to you. And then you can go back to factory default. Now I'm not gonna do that because then that'll mess up all the presets that I have stored here. And so what I do is then I go through and I create a couple banks that I like and I store them on the computer. For instance, this active bank I have is my live thing that I would normally use. My favorite preset that I'm gonna use with Steve, the one we just heard was coils 1 and 2 in parallel, which I love from the Sterling bank. Actually, this one. Now that's a nice slap sound for me, but if I want something a little fatter, I actually use a sound that incorporates the four coils. Now you can hear how much more bottom end that brings in, because I'm now using coils 3 and 4, which, of course, being the neck coils, are gonna bring in more bassy stuff like that. So I do that. Then I have coil 1 down here for my finger style stuff. Now I like that for, you know, Jaco kind of things or funky things, but for slap, not so good. So that's why I like to be able to switch between the sounds. So anyway, I can put any variety of sounds there, and that's most of my live rig. Then on the passive bank, all I do is lift up this knob, and all of a sudden I have five other sounds. Now what I stored, and I've done a couple different banks, which is the really neat feature. I have a bank of entirely slap sounds that I've stored on there. I've also made a bank of what comes with the HH Sterling bass, which comes with the HS Sterling bass. So if I want to draw on any of those sounds, I can just load them up. Here, what I have in this passage bank is what I call my vintage sounds. So we're looking towards things like a P bass or an Offroad bass or a Gibson. Right. Now that was just coil 3. Pretty honky up here, kind of to me reminiscent of a P bass. If I go to just coil 4, which is in the second position. Right, similar, but if you had a good system, you'd hear the differences between it. That's a little more of a Gibson bass than a position 3. Different yet again. So anyway, I have five sounds that I consider to be vintage sounding on this bank. And if I'm in a recording session, and the producer goes, that's not quite it. Do you have anything else? Yeah. Do you have anything else? Yeah. Do you have anything else? Yeah. I don't have to switch the bass every time. And then if that's not it, then I can even go to here or back to there if there's not enough. But that's my main application for it at this point. And I'm just going to keep storing more banks as I find sound. I don't have any of the weird out-of-phase stuff on here yet, but that's yet to come. As soon as I get home, I'll be exploring that.
GuitarPlanet.com.au.